Hi, for today's teardown, this. It was shipped on French eBay because of the condition. In particular, it was missing the glass. I managed to find a replacement glass in my stock and reinstall it, but also the main indicator needle here is missing, and it is not possible to replace it very easily. I have no stock for a replacement needle anyway. So we have here old school aircraft instrument, of course. What is it? Gyromagnetic compass Mark V, indicator heading type A, reference number 6BQ656, serial number 573 apparently, and after there is a 65, so it may be the manufacturing date. And yes, Brodaro, of course, British made. About the brand, there is not really a brand on this thing. You can notice there is a different serial number on the dial here. So not sure. Seems to be Smith's, but so we have main wheel here for the compass. Missing the indicator here. Heading settings that will turn the crown here all around. Sync something, not sure what it does. Some kind of a reset button also. Some kind of flags that are not moving actually, currently at least. And here some kind of adjustment you can access with a small triangular key here. Okay, briefing holes on the back. A whole bunch of very British connectors, old school, and I do not think I have any matching plugs for these ones. They are pretty old. I have some on equipment, but I have no matching connectors. Fuse holder in the middle, quite unusual to see a fuse holder on an aircraft instrument. Regular backlight one, two big screws to secure the case. On the front, you can notice I did remove some of the screws which are securing the whole front to the case. And about these screws, they are very, very weird because they are the diameter of an imperial screw, but not the regular thread you will find on the an imperial screw of this diameter, and it is not metric thread also. So I cannot lose these screws because really they are not replaceable. I did try a number of screws in my stock and nothing fixed. Quite weird. Also about the buttons, they are just secured by a pin that I did manage to lose. I did put them in a plastic bag like this. And I lost the plastic bag, but I made an other pins from electronic component legs. Seemed to work pretty well. Also, the backlight here was broken, and I repaired it with a trick of super glue and baking soda. And really, I was not expecting such a result. Look at this. There was a whole part missing here, and really, I am quite happy. So, if I find again the original pins, I will reinstall them. But it is temporary fix here until I find something better. But it works for now, and it is not possible to see it very much. Anyways, okay, now let's have a look inside, of course. So it will be very quick with two big screws remaining at the back. And as you can expect, we are mostly actuators in this thing. So quite a serious aluminum case. And here is what we have, a whole pile of stuff actually. This seems to be mainly terminal board to interconnect the wires from the connectors to the other wires inside. No real electronic components on it, just solder paste like this. You can see the heating here button that will you need to push it actually to engage it and have some action. It will turn this device so it is full of synchros or motors or things like this. But sadly, the labels for them are all hidden in the middle, and it is not possible to read really what they are. What else? On the front, more terminals. Some calls to actuate the flags, it seems, but they are not really easy to reach. Here also. Unknown device here. One more here. Oh, this one maybe will move. Yes. This one, it is the off flag. Will move like this. But the other one, I do not believe I can reach it easily. So we have here in the middle a whole bunch of actuators. You can see the very British wire looms with pink heat shrink and the blue lacing here. Interesting, very very impressive work here with the wires. So this thing here, you will see it will actuate another device which seems to be stuck. By the way, there is a yes, it is not turning. There is a safety system, a clutch or something within. It will not turn, but it will engage a contact here. Wow, look at this here. This is really some work. And a lot of terminals going to this. Device, no idea what it is. You can see we have apparently two stages with each time four contacts. Maybe it is a dual potentiometer with middle point or something like this. More gears here at the back. Rotating, I'm not even sure what. Yes, the main big large dial on the front. So about the middle indicator that is broken and completely stuck, it must be this set of gears, but this will not turn at all. You can see here we have rotary contacts going in this device, wipers. Okay. I did check and really no electronic components on the back of this plate. More devices here, more cable lacing. So really, really a beautiful device. A little bit sad it is not in a better condition. And also no brand. One more time, one more serial number here. Again, another one. Interesting. And again, 65. So I guess 65 must really be the manufacturing date. We have a big rubber seal at the back. And again, the connector number. We notice it goes to C9, but we have only five connectors. Quite weird British stuff. Okay, so this is stuck also. So either there is a clutch somewhere, or the device is really stuck completely. Not sure what happened with the main indicator needle, which was broken. You can see it was here in the middle of the screw. Well, no screw, a whole shaft going here in the middle, so I cannot easily extract it and replace it. All what I can do is try to find a needle with a big center part which I could drill to match this diameter and try to press fit in here, maybe. But for now, I have nothing of this kind available. Okay. So really nice instrument, and I did pay only. Actually, it was 30 € with another one, which I do not know. It is here. I will show you real quick. 30 € with this one. Just a regular galvanometer movement in here, probably. Not worth opening. And it is still factory sealed. So it is from Braillon-Leroux, Paris. The code 68, big serial number, and some kind of a pressure indicator with a nice schematics here. Old school connector with only three contacts. And my inventory number, which is recycled. I did exceed the 700. And you can see very nice blue here. Enamel. Anodized aluminium. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.